Well, come Friday, California will be the first state in the country to ban trans fats in restaurants. Governor Schwarzenegger signed the measure last year, and restaurants have had the past year to get ready. Action News reporter Mae Chow is live in Salinas to tell us if they're prepared.
Dan, also known as partially hydrogenated oils, trans fat has been linked to clogged arteries, stroke, and heart disease. And many restaurants here on the Central Coast already have made transitions and changes to their menu to comply with the new law. It's what gives French fries, pastries, and cookies their texture and distinct flavors. The not-so-secret ingredient, trans fat or hydrogenated oils, known to be a health hazard. The artificial artery-clogging fats are used in many fried and processed foods, but now the state of California has a law that bars restaurants from using trans fats.
People are obese in this world, and I think the restaurants will look, you know, it'll be a good thing.
I think it's good. It's great because, you know, we try to give better health to people, right?
Ronaldo Mendoza says his restaurant has always cooked with 100% soybean oil. Many restaurants use trans fatty oils because it's cheaper and can be reused over and over again to fry foods. But starting January 1st, restaurants who use trans fat can be fined up to $1,000. The new ban will be monitored by routine inspections by the local health department.
I think it's going to be a little hard because there's so many people, you know, but if they keep enforcing the law, you know, we have to be ready for.
Mendoza says his restaurant will stop using margarine, a product which has some of the highest amounts of trans fat, on Friday, and he'll work with bakeries to make sure the breads have no hydrogenated oils.
So what exactly is trans fat? It's when hydrogen is added to vegetable oil to improve the shelf life and enhance the flavor of foods. This process turns the oil into solid fat, such as margarine and shortening, and then add it to certain foods, such as crackers, cookies, and cereals.
But it's not just found in snack foods. Walk down any aisle in the grocery store and you'll find some even unexpected foods contain trans fat, such as peanut butter, ice cream, and coffee creamer.
People need to become smarter shoppers. Even though a product may say on the front that it contains 0 grams of trans fat, if you turn it around and read the ingredients, it says hydrogenated oils.
So now that the state has banned trans fat from restaurant kitchens, consumers will have to make healthy choices in their own kitchens. While the new law helps control what people put in their bodies while eating out, it is still in their hands to eat healthy at home.
One more thing to add, trans fat raises your bad cholesterol, your LDL, and lowers your good cholesterol, which is HDL, increasing your risk for heart disease, which is, Dan, the number one killer for both men and women.
All right, thanks very much. Appreciate it, May. The law will not go into effect, though, for bakeries until January of 2011. Now, New York City was the first city in the country to ban trans fat. Since then, more than a dozen have followed suit.